Hello guys, this is the fourth problem of homework 5. The assembly consists of two 10 mm diameter red brass CA3400 copper rods A, B and C, D, a 15 diameter 304 stainless steel rod EF, and a rigid bar G. The modulus of elasticity for the red brass C83400 is 101 gigapascals. For 304 stainless steel is 193 gigapascals. If the horizontal displacement of NF of rod EF is 0.38 millimeters, determine the magnitude of P. So first, this problem we're gonna break in. We're gonna make two section cuts. The first section cut here, one, and the second one here. So start with number one. We have our cut. Here we have 4P, and here we have our N1. So we can do the sum of the forces equals zero. So we have 4P minus N1 equals zero. So we have our N1 equals 4P. Now we can find our displacement. Displacement 1 equals N1 times original length over modulus of elasticity times area. So our displacement 1 equals N1 is 4P times the original length 450 millimeters over 193 times 10 to the 9 pascals times P over 4 times 15 times 10 to the minus 3 converting to meters square. So our first displacement is equal 0.05278 times 10 to the minus 3 P. This is our displacement. Now we're gonna do the analysis of the second section cut. So our second section cut is here. So we have here we have 4P, here we have P, here we have P, and here we have our N2 and N2. So we know the sum of the forces equals zero. We have 2N2 plus 2P minus 4P equals zero. So I have 2N2 equals 2P. I know my N2 equals P. So I know the displacement in rod AB is the same of the displacement of rod CD, that equals N2 times original length over modulus of elasticity times my area. So we know that our displacement AB equals N2P times original length 300 millimeters over modulus of elasticity is 101 times 10 to the 9 pascals times P over 4 times 10 times 10 to the minus 3 is squared to convert in meters. So I know the displacement NB will be 0.03782 times 10 to the minus 3 P. Now check our units here. I don't know, but I know here is in millimeters. Here I know it's in newton per meter square, and here is meter square. So our and here our displacement, it has to give us in millimeters if we say our P is in newtons. So this is in millimeters as the first displacement. Now we know that all deformation of my assembly is equal to the deformation 1 plus the deformation in AB. I don't need to add the two rods AB and CD because they are in parallel. So if they are in parallel, they have the same stretch. So I just need to add one of them, not AB plus CD. So by the exercise, I have 0.38 millimeters equals 0.05278 times 10 to the minus 3 B in millimeters plus 0.03782 times 10 to the minus 3 P millimeters as well. So here I have P equals 0.38 over 0.0906 times 10 to the minus 3. So I found that my P is 4.19 times 10 to the 3 newtons, or if you want to put your answer in kilonewtons, 4.19 kilonewtons. This is our final answer for problem 4.